Hey guys, welcome back to The Market is Open. Check out our website, themarketisopen.com. So today, Tesla stock skyrocketed on seemingly very little news. The stock soared almost 20% or $129 to close at $780 per share, an all-time high for the company, valuing it at $140 billion in market cap. That makes Tesla the second largest auto company in the world, just behind Toyota, which is valued at $199 billion. Last week, we saw Tesla jump from the mid-$500 range to the mid-$600 range. So why did Tesla jump another 20% today? In this video, we're going to go over four possible reasons why this may have happened, and perhaps it was a combination of these reasons. But first, hit the bell button to subscribe to our YouTube channel and be notified when we post a new video. Also, smash the like button to help support this video. Okay, so the first thing I saw most people attribute the move to was an upgrade by an analyst at Argus, Bill Seleski, who upgraded the stock from $556 a share to $808, citing that the Model 3 is driving Tesla's demand, and also Tesla just came off the back of a strong earnings report. It's kind of funny actually how these analysts raise their price targets as soon as Tesla blows through their previous price targets. Just because the stock reaches your target, why does the target need to change? Especially since they just updated their price target to $556 less than 1 month ago. So Argus says, despite past production delays, parts shortages, labor cost overruns, and other difficulties, we expect Tesla to benefit from its dominant position in the electric vehicle industry. So I think this is a huge testament to Tesla that even with both hands tied behind their backs, I mean, Tesla's had tons of production hell problems. People thought they were going bankrupt just 6 to 9 months ago. They're fighting the dealerships. They've had big problems moving into Europe and even China last year. And especially in terms of what Argus wrote, Elon constantly reiterates that if just one part of the vehicle is delayed, the production line moves as fast as the slowest part. A big reason why Tesla has actually had no other choice but to bring a lot of their production in-house. So they also did have labor cost overruns and they did have to lay people off last year. So despite all of these problems, no one else has put a vehicle out even remotely close to any Tesla vehicle today at the same price point. No one can even beat the 2012 Model S still, which hints at least an 8-year lead. But on top of that, they're doing solar and battery storage and autonomous driving with their own custom chips. So I agree with Argus that despite these setbacks, Tesla continues to push through. Also, speaking of crazy price targets, ARK Invest, which has that famous $4,000 price target on Tesla, also put out their updated 5-year price target this weekend, which was an expected value of $7,000 per share for Tesla. That's even more bullish than Argus. So we'll probably make a separate video about this to talk about what ARK Invest has to say. Again, I like ARK Invest's research, but we already knew that they had a crazy price target. And so neither of these analysts had said anything brand new today that would have caused the stock to spike 20% on their own. It's also interesting, I was listening to a Morningstar analyst, David Whiston, who has a $326 price target on Tesla stock as of the end of January, which was just a couple of days ago. However, the stock in January was in the mid-600s, at about $640 per share, and he said that this is actually the most positive he's ever been on Tesla stock. He even said that he thinks Tesla remains the dominant EV player, and although GM has done some amazing stuff, no one seems to care at all, he says. So I don't see why his price target calls for a 50% drop in Tesla's price. So part of my thinking is that a lot of these analysts have been wrong about Tesla. They've been reluctant to change their minds because the stock looks expensive, but it keeps getting more expensive and they're missing out. So I think they need to buy, and they need to buy meaningful positions for their firms to show their clients, look, we didn't miss out on this gigantic run. We're smart and we own Tesla. So I think these guys are some of the buyers of Tesla stock, and maybe if not today, then eventually. But I think they're part of why Tesla stock increased so much today. Actually, one thing I would like to point out was that he said that, well, in the end, Tesla's still a car company, and of course their costs are going to be quite high to make these vehicles. But I think he doesn't understand. Tesla seems to have pulled out a lot of the expensive things, besides the batteries, out of vehicles. So the cost to produce cars in the future will actually be cheaper as the price of batteries come down. There's actually very few components left in a car. So I think that's why these analysts' models might be off by a little bit. Okay, the second point I have for why Tesla jumped $129 in one day. If you bought stock at $260 just a few months ago, just today the stock went up 50% of your initial investment. Okay, so the second point is that Panasonic reported that they were profitable on Tesla's U.S. battery business. So I think this is another testament to Elon Musk, who when asked on the conference call a couple months ago, maybe about 6 months ago, if they were going to add more Panasonic lines to the Gigafactory, he said no, which was kind of strange. If Tesla needs batteries, why not add as many lines as possible? And remember that Panasonic works closely with Tesla at the Gigafactory in Nevada. And so the reason why Elon Musk didn't need more production lines was that Panasonic had already added about 34 gigawatt hours of production capacity. However, Tesla was only utilizing about 23 gigawatt hours. So the focus was on improving the throughput and the efficiency and the yield of these lines, and not simply adding more inefficient lines. So last we heard, I believe Tesla said they had increased this to 28 gigawatt hours, which was a few months ago, so they're likely closer to that 34 gigawatt hour capacity now. But that also means that the same machinery can produce more. So less capital investment, less fixed costs, and just the cost of the materials to get way more batteries, which also helps to explain the increase in Model 3s produced in the fourth quarter, and of course why Panasonic was profitable. Panasonic's CFO said, "We're catching up as Tesla is quickly expanding production. Higher production volume is helping to push down material costs and erase losses." So I think this hints that Tesla continues to expand battery production, which is extremely bullish news. They're cutting costs and making more batteries, exactly what investors want to hear. The fact that Panasonic was profitable doesn't really matter a whole lot for Tesla, but clearly this investment is paying off for Panasonic and it's good for both companies. Okay, now sort of related to batteries, General Motors had paid millions of dollars to promote its new electric Hummer during the Super Bowl, which may be launched in 2022, assuming that they're not late. So I think they're going to be late because I don't see how GM will be getting these batteries for this vehicle, especially if the Cybertruck is coming out around that time and aims to crush anything in its path. And I do think that there is some overlap between potential Hummer buyers and Cybertruck buyers who want a large, cool-looking car. But that said, Tesla can't really make the Cybertruck at scale because of battery shortages. I predict that GM will run into the same battery shortages, especially since a Hummer will be using tons of batteries relative to a sedan or an SUV or even the Cybertruck. So my bet is that the Hummer, which was a gas guzzler in a previous life, will be a battery hog in its new life and will likely arrive late to meet some Tesla competition. So the $5 million for the 1 second of electric Hummer advertising seems more like an ad for Tesla. And remember, Tesla, we know, hasn't paid for advertising at all. I think people will compare the Hummer to the Cybertruck, and there's going to be a big disparity, just like the Model S and the Taycan, and then buyers will have to make a wise decision. So this brings me to my third point, which I believe may have helped Tesla spike today, which was a deal with CATL, C-A-T-L, a Chinese battery manufacturer for Tesla's China operations. We know that Tesla already has a deal with LG Chem from South Korea for battery supplies. And Elon has also mentioned CATL on the conference call quite recently. So this is still a pretty big deal. Tesla is tying up all major suppliers of batteries, and they're going to need even more batteries than that. Do you remember when Ron Barron said that GM's Mary Barra, the CEO, instructed her supply chain to use Tesla suppliers even if they cost more? So that's not really a nice move, but it's smart for GM. If you can't compete with Tesla on product, just try to slow them down. So I think the opposite seems to be happening, where Tesla scored three of the major battery makers in the world, and they're going to be ramping up the Model 3, the Model Y, Semi, Cybertrucks. Basically, they need as many batteries as they can get, and there's no end in sight. Also, now Tesla is the 780-pound gorilla in the room, and you can't ignore the $140 billion market cap, which is almost triple the size of GM's, but the fact that they produce the most electric vehicles out of anyone in the world makes them the largest buyers of batteries. So who do you think LG Chem and CATL and Panasonic want to do business with? Of course, Tesla, with the highest volume and huge plans to ramp up. So effectively, Tesla is the first to take up a lot of the supplier capacity. Of course, they'll be able to support other customers as well. The suppliers, I'm not saying that they won't. I just think it's funny how GM was trying to screw over Tesla, and now coincidentally, GM may have a tough time to get battery capacity at scale of its own. I guess a good analogy of this is Foxconn builds Apple iPhones along with many, many other customers. If there's a shortage of a particular chip, for example, that goes into phones, and only one customer can get it, who do you think that customer is going to be? The one largest customer who, if they drop you, you lose half your revenue? Or someone else? Like, take a guess. So I think Tesla is becoming the Apple of the auto industry, if they haven't already, but in terms of the supply chain for batteries. And finally, the fourth reason that I think that Tesla jumped 20% today has to do with a combination of a few things we already talked about, but this is a major short squeeze that's happening in Tesla stock. And Elon's pretty funny, he posted some burning flames for the shorts. So since October, we can see some massive short covering each month from 37 million shares shorted down to about 24 million in the middle of January. But even though the shorts are covering, the dollar amount remains the same, if not much higher, because the share price keeps going up. Right now, Tesla has about 24 million shares shorted, and although the days to cover says one day over here, I don't think that's the case, and that number is kind of meaningless because it just divides the number of shares shorted by the volume. If you actually tried to sell, you'd run into all of the regular buyers and sellers that are there day to day. Anyways, the real beauty of short covering is shown here in this short example. Say there's one share of Tesla in total, and I own it. Woohoo, that would be amazing. But a short seller comes by and he finds a loophole. He asks the bank if he can borrow that one share and sell it in the hopes of buying it back later at a lower price. Effectively, he's shorting this one share. So by doing that, that actually increases the supply of the shares in the open market. Now there's two shares floating around because there's two owners, me and the guy who bought the imaginary borrowed share that came out of thin air and that the short seller sold. So by the classic rules of supply and demand, more supply and the same demand would reduce the price of the actual stock, which is exactly what the short seller wants to knock the price down. And you saw that the short sellers did this in October, or leading up to October, with 37 million shares, additional shares, that are trading in the market due to short sellers. Not only does the sell order from the short seller knock the price down, but it creates excess supply, which further takes down the price. However, the opposite is true as well, that when the short sellers need to cover, they have to buy back that share that they borrowed, which removes a share from the open market. The market is open, just kidding. But a share is removed and we're back to the original one share, which decreases the supply again back to normal. However, in Tesla's case, investors were used to the fact that there were 37 million shares outstanding, or 24 million shares outstanding. They were buyers of these extra shares that were holding Tesla stock. So now we get some good news, just like we did today. A few upgrades, a battery deal, some great news from Panasonic. Normally, this may not move the stock too much, but Tesla's been the most heavily shorted stock that there is. So what happens? Well, people see this news and they want to buy the stock. But now there's a limited supply because the short sellers have covered so much. They've brought the share count, shorted share count from 37 million to 24 million. So the price goes up even more as investment firms who haven't bought and smarter retail investors are buying shares. The short sellers start to lose money and so they need to cover even more, which means that they need to buy, which causes the price to go up even more. And that causes there to be even less supply because when they buy back, the share's gone. They have to give it back to the bank. And they would need to borrow a new share in order to short it again. Anyways, the mother of all short squeezes that Elon Musk had warned short sellers about is happening, and that along with some great news gave some fuel to spark this huge rally to $780 in Tesla today. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Please hit the bell button to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We could really use your support to help grow the channel. And also smash the like button to help support this video. Thanks so much for watching.